Most witchers do not kill dragons, for they are sentient and highly intelligent creatures. Some dragons, on the other hand, are a danger to humans, a danger that has to be dealt with. And there was one witcher who became known for his pursuit of dragons, George of Kagan, known as George the Dragon Slayer. As a child, George was trained in Kaer Seren, the witcher fortress of the School of the Griffin. The Griffin School put an emphasis on virtues, and they have had a more positive outlook on people. They trust them more than the other schools do, which can sometimes be very dangerous for them. But George stood out from most of the other witchers, for he seemed to have an obsession with the dragons. At some point in his life, while George was in Temeria, he heard a rumor of a dragon that had made its home in the Crookback Hills in Velen. If it was up to him, he would have charged straight towards the beast. However, he was dragged away from his hunt due to the fact that he was summoned by the prefects of Corsvelen. George needed to provide a professional testimony about some ghost activity near a lighthouse. Recently, the lighthouse keeper, Bartoslav of Lovefield, had been accused of luring ships onto the rock so that they could be looted. But Bartoslav, who was innocent, thought it was in fact the glow of nitrates that lured the ships onto the rocks, not his lighthouse. George took a look around the area of the lighthouse and found no signs of activity from nitrates, nunrates, mamoons, urnymphs, or any other creature that may create a light. But he did learn what the real cause was. The son of the lighthouse keeper showed George ashes that he had found along the coast, from which they concluded, instead of any type of wraith being the cause, instead what it was were local hooligans who lured the ships to be looted. But it seems the fire was actually not caused by local hooligans, but instead by the lightkeeper's son, who was practicing his smithing skills, for he didn't want to take over his father's job in the lighthouse. George, once he was done, went as quickly as he could to the burnt down villages in Velen to ask the survivors around about the dragon. The survivors told him the following. The dragon had ashen scales. The height at haunches was about 2 fathoms, which is a tiny bit shorter than 2 Geralt's. The length of the beast was about 5 fathoms, which was roughly translated to a bit less than 5 Geralt's. The dragon could also breathe fire for more than 15 minutes straight. Due to these points, George concluded that it was a green dragon. He made some of the worst mistakes he could, however. George's sword was damaged from a previous contract, and whilst he ordered a new one to be made, he was such in haste that he didn't wait until the sword was finished. On top of that, he had so much faith in his armor that he believed it would protect him from the dragon's fire and poison. Let's just say he made a mistake. Even though he killed the dragon, the witcher George was badly hurt and had one foot in the grave. He was placed into the care of a man named Balstick, who took care of him in Hindholt. With the right care, George would have survived, but he of course didn't receive the right care. Balstick, instead of helping him restore him back to health, eased his passing, in a way killing the witcher. For he saw an opportunity to profit. For Balstick was not only slightly evil, he was also stupid. He didn't know what witcher's potions were, and thought they were some kind of alcoholic beverage. He died by drinking the potion, obviously, killed by his own greed. George's body would be laid to rest in Dragon Slayer's Grotto, and their story would be remembered. In the halls of Kaer Morhen, the mentors of the Wolf School had a fresco painted on the wall to teach the young witchers about his story, about his bravery, and about his misguided faith in humans. The young wolf witchers, however, didn't seem to care that much, as they defaced the painting by drawing mustaches, beards, and other things on it. If George had taken his time and prepared for the fight with the dragon, he would have most likely survived his fight. However, he didn't, and it cost him his life. So, what do you think about the witcher George? Till the next video. Bye.